Yo guys, what's up? Episode 37 of Beasts of the Wild today. We're going to Canada in this video. And here in the forest, I only spotted the hoary bat. You can see where it gets its name from straight away. The hoary bat. It's the largest of all Canadian bat species, but I don't get to catch more of them here on Creek. It's like wet work. One VO and a victory, and we're off to the northern part of Canada to do some snow game hunting. The Canadian goose is the first one to go down, but it's so easy to shoot accidental headshots on him. Knife does the work though. The Canada lynx jumps over the wall and comes clawing in at me. That's a bad kitty. The lynx used to live in Belgium as well, but now they only live in Germany and I guess France and maybe Luxembourg. I got some more geese coming in as well. Well, they don't call them geese because they are smart. I'm patiently awaiting more geese lying in this dark, misty hallway. Snakes are gonna be fed tonight. But that means that the claymores are gone. After that, we seek refuge in a location that we already know, but the Arctic wolf was waiting for me. It ate the old lady that lived in this house, but I don't feel like putting rocks in its belly and sending it down the river. That would be too cruel. If you want to see guts, we got an animal coming up with a transparent belly. But first, I got a call from my team in Africa because they spotted a very rare creature. So I practiced my new Bushmaster tactic on this passing zebra because the Bushmaster is the largest venomous snake in the entire world. It can swallow a zebra like that. And what do you think of my brand new SMG camo? Time to put theory into action because I smell a lot of potential customers for this one. We're hunting the okapi, body like a horse, head like a giraffe, with a very long tongue. It has a brown color with some white stripes, and he lives in the African rainforest. It's an amazing creature. You could actually see it as a small giraffe. It's very, very elegant. But the spider monkey, that's not a special one. Head on the wall, body fed to the stakes on overgrown. I hope I can go to overgrown soon, because it's starting to smell a bit funky in my backyard with all those dead wild goats and small monkeys lying around. We also made a city trip to Cuba for another rat problem. Claymores set up, relocation. Claymores go off. Mole coming in. The mole. He must have thought I was a teammate or something, or was he too focused on the deceased rat? Next rat dies as a result of the honey badger tactic. So the UAV is good to go. Like a fair de lance, I bring another rat to justice. I'm having trouble with the stairs though. Next episode, fair de lance versus mole. Mole dies. Relocation required for the airstrike, so I put up over here again. And while I'm curiously checking the miserable effect of my airstrike, I got another rat coming in. I quickly run away so I can get the chopper, but somebody decides differently. The glass frog. He has a see-through belly, a transparent belly so you can see his intestines. And after this random grenade, well, everyone can see his intestines. 7v1, the glass frog took me down, so yeah, no 15KD today. I've seen that little jump on Ghost ID 656 channel. It's very annoying for me to play against people who use that stupid jump. Back to Canada then, because we're returning for a huge trophy. One that will take up an entire wall in my office. If it lowers his head, it means he's gunning for you. The moose is an extremely powerful being. It can easily knock over a small car. I test out another hideout and spot the Canada lynx again. On the sofa, bad kitty. Biblical Reaper sleeps on that couch. How dare you? My claymores take down another moose. I wonder how it will taste. And thanks to my night vision, I survived the attack of this Arctic wolf, a very old one. The last of them are the Arctic foxes. Yes, foxes. A mommy and a baby fox. And mommy is dropping grenades. My teammate makes sure that their family shall be reunited in Arctic fox heaven, Valhalla. So a trip to Canada brought lots of fortune, but the glass frog, he was too clever for me on the previous one. We got a lot of victories today, so I'm happy for that. Canada helped us reach level 40, which means a P90 SMG. That's 23 kills and 1 death, 15 KD still within reach, and a stronger starting position for next time. See you on the next one, guys. Peace.